one you've been waiting for, a Pro Wrestling USA main event. A six-man tag team battle. Introducing now in the ring, from Amarillo, Texas, weighing 250 pounds, the bounty hunter, Terry Funk. From Beverly Hills, California, weighing 248 pounds, former heavyweight champion of the world, Nick Bockwinkel. Gentlemen, from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, weighing 217 pounds, the AWA light heavyweight champion of the world, Mr. Electricity, Steve Regal. And now, ladies and gentlemen, approaching the ring area for this big six-man tag team main event, here they come. And here they come into the ring, introducing, first of all, from Robbinsdale, Minnesota, weighing 235 pounds, part of the Axe Attack, Kurt Hennig. His tag team partners, the High Flyers, from White Bear Lake, Minnesota, weighing 232 pounds, Jumpin' Jim Brunson. From Mound, Minnesota, weighing 218 pounds, Greg Gagne. This six-man tag team main event, your referee, Marty Miller.
Well, we're all set to go. This should be a wild one. You've got six fantastic athletes in there. Look at Funk taking a shot at a towel with against Greg. Greg Gagne.
Well, here we go, Bern Gagne. Greg will step in against former heavyweight champion Nick Bockwinkel. And look at the way they look at each other. Greg Gagne back after an almost debilitating injury that's kept him out of action for several months. Seems to be right back in his old form. High-flying form. And I know he wanted to get back and get back to it. He got tired of watching it. Here he goes. Working with Nick Bockwinkel. They split off the ropes. Long-time holder of that heavyweight championship belt, Nick Bockwinkel.
Yes, he certainly was.
Working now on Greg Gagne on the ropes. First over and then under. Drags him off the ropes. Smash into the turnbuckle. Oh, look at that. Right to the midsection. Greg turned it around. Look at that. And down goes Bockwinkel. A great combination by Greg Gagne. The former champ again. Caught him with one side of a flying drop kick, and that was enough to send Bockwinkel rolling under the bottom rope and out of the ring. After just one set two with Greg Gagne. These are the two starters. Neither man has tagged yet. You see now, your son Greg Gagne, what a great feeling it must be to see him not only competing, but as one of the top competitors in pro wrestling today, Bern.
Well, thank you, Doug. Greg and Jim Brunzel, they've been the world tag team champions for a while. Ooh. There's a big left there by Funk with those taped hands.
Oh.
A block. He's got that boy. Oh.
Funk almost deep-sixed himself over the ropes. Now, Greg slams it back to the turnbuckle. Did they make a tag? I guess so. Here comes Kurt Hennig. I tell you, Greg doesn't want to let this one go, does he?
No, he don't. He's got to watch it. You know, he's very eager to get back in that ring, but he can't be too eager. He's got to tag off like he did.
Oh,
look at that right hand.
But here comes Steve Regal. They made the tag, apparently, and Funk leaves the ring. But Kurt Hennig, off the rope. Bern Gagne, he must have been 20 feet there.
It sure seemed like it, Doug.
I'll tell you, Kurt Hennig latched hold of him, and Steve Regal, Mr. Electricity, went for a plane ride.
You've got three in that corner that are very, very tough wrestlers, and that's inside the ring. Steve Regal, the light heavyweight champion, missed another miss.
Beautiful.
Oh, great move. What a beautiful move. There's the tag, and here comes jumping Jim Brunsell. Was that a beautiful combination?
Yes, it was.
Now, Funk tried to get in the ring for a minute, and so does Clockwinkle. I'll tell you, Jim Brunsell's got this one under control for the moment. And now, look at this. Jim Brunsell polishes off Regal. Slaps to the side of the head of Clockwinkle. Working on Clockwinkle, but now back comes the bounty hunter, Terry Funk. Into that classic boxing stance now.
Punching out, throwing punches at him with those taped up hands, Doug. You know, I want to say, when you got the combination of the AWA and the National Wrestling Alliance, you got some fantastic talent, and the matches show it. I mean, this is a wildest, as wild a tag team as I've ever seen.
Incredible. A jam-packed capacity crowd enjoying this one. Wherever you're seeing it, whether it be New York, San Francisco, Las Vegas, Denver, and also our friends in Winnipeg, Vancouver, Windy City, Chicago, Dallas, Fort Worth, and all the mid-cities. Boy, is this wrestling action. Right, wrist lock, but look at this now. Whoa, and Funk got his way out of it, but...
Tremendous back suplex by Funk. Don't forget, he's a former NWA heavyweight champion of the world. He's a very, very tough wrestler. Jim Brunsell's got his hands full. What a contest here. Hey, look at this. And then Jim reverses it.
Oh, look at that.
Jim Brunsell.
Tremendous move.
Remaining time, 2 minutes.
2 minutes to go in this match. They're going to go for this falls if they can get it.
Look at this. Greg is ready to go. Off of the corner. Here's Clockwinkle. Oh. Slam to the turnbuckle. Greg Gagne.
Oh, he
missed the flying drop kick. And Clockwinkle just hit the brakes. Not a moment too soon.
Oh,
a
sleeper hold. The sleeper.
Here's Clockwinkle. Can Greg kick out of this one?
That's a tough one to get out of.
Oh. Several versions of that sleeper, which you yourself made famous, and Clockwinkle is using one on Greg now. Oh, and effectively, apparently.
And it looks like it's right across that throat, but the referee is in there close. He's got to watch it.
Right between the... It does look like it's slipping off that chin. Can Greg get out of this one?
Greg, you got to get out of there. You got to get up. Into the turnbuckle.
Yes, sir. That broke the hold, but it's right back on again. But back to the turnbuckle again. Now, Greg, of course...
He's got to tag off. He's got to get out of there. Oh, a nice throw off.
1 minute remaining.
Oh, reversal. A sleeper hold. Reverse. Greg has got it on.
Look at this.
Clockwinkle. Greg Gagne got that. Oh, here.
Now Funk
in the ring.
Now here we go. Everybody in the ring. Funk started it. Then Hennig attacked Steve Regal. Now they go off the ropes. Look at this, and it's still Clockwinkle and Greg Gagne.
Oh,
tremendous collision.
Come on, somebody's got a tag out here.
30 seconds remaining.
Here comes Funk over the top rope as he tries to attack Jim Brunsell. Now Regal and Kenny.
Look at this.
They slam to the corner, everybody getting to go.
It's out of hand. It's out of hand here.
We'll see what the time is.
Clockwinkle. And a kickoff by Greg.
Everybody at it. He's got a
train. The referee's trying to get order in here. 10 seconds remaining. 5, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4 seconds. 3, 2, 1. That's it. Time has expired. But they're still going at it, Vern Gagne.
They're not quitting, Doug. They're out on our table here. These big bodies coming all over the place.
This is
and they're fighting and kicking.
And Jim Brunsell right on top of us.
Punk's going bananas and Jim Brunsell in after. What did he call it?
Referee Marty Miller has declared the match a draw.
Disqualified the two teams because for getting out of order.
Well,
I guess
think
time expired.
Had it gone another few seconds, Vern Gagne, I think we would have either had a pin or just complete mayhem and out of order. Now, here's how it wound up. Greg is really working on Nick Clockwinkle.
Caught him with a beautiful cradle.
Yeah, there's a...
And there it is. He's got him flat. The referee is not around. He's being bothered by... That's Mr. Funk kicked him off.
That's a good four count already. But not seen, and so it doesn't go in the book.
Tremendous action here. Pro Wrestling USA.
Incredible action.
Ladies and gentlemen, again, we want to remind you, tomorrow night, Star Wars 1985 at the Meadowlands. If we can, perhaps we can net now. We see Nick Bockwinkel and Terry Funk coming over along with Steve Regal. But remember, $100,000 on the line. Former NWA champion, former AWA champion, team together in quest of $100,000.
If there's not enough knowledge there, then you tell me where you can find it.
Let me tell you something. There's an NWA champion, there's an AWA champion, and there's some steroid freaks that claim they're champions. But there's only two COC champions. What that is champion of champions, and excuse me, it's me and Bockwinkel. We're going after that money, and believe me, you egg-sucking dogs, we're going to get it.
There's a lot of people who seem to think, because as he said, the muscles and the steroids and all the things that make people big and tough, that's going to get it done. It takes a lot more. It takes desire. You have to be down and dirty in the nitty-gritty. You have to love this sport. You have to have been to the top of the mountain long enough to appreciate it. He has, and I have. What? I even have differences with this man right here.
That's right, Bockwinkel.
I'll tell you one thing.
We'll
I
take
have
them
to
on.
Respect your integrity as you must respect mine.
You have to respect them.
Yes.
My intelligence. We'll take them on 2x4, too.
Well,
four
I'll tell
four.
You, talk about strange bedfellows. All right, Larry Zbyszko, you'll be teamed up with gorgeous Jimmy Garvin in quest of $100,000.
Well, you know, all I got to say is this, Ken. The people of New York area, they know who I am. They know who the living legend of professional wrestling is. They know the accomplishments that I have acquired. They know the background.
Now, as I understand, indeed, congratulations are due you, recently returning from Mexico as the new America champion.
You know, I had a very successful tour down in Mexico. I wound up with what I rightly deserve, American Heavyweight Championship. And I tell you something, a legend doesn't stop here. We're going all the way to the top, to Martel, anybody.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, remember, tomorrow night at the Meadowlands, Star Wars 1985 $100,000 Tag Team Challenge and three World Championship bouts. We'll be right back. Next week, right here on Pro Wrestling USA, a tremendous card. You'll be seeing in action the Youngblood Brothers, Terry Funk, the tag team of Jerry Blackwell and Sergeant Slaughter, and Larry Zbyszko. I have just learned that you are signed to defend the newly won America title against none other than the great Bob Backlund.
Okay, well, number one, he's not great. Number two, the people here have got to realize that I know what I'm talking about. You know something, Ken? We're sending people up in space shuttles. We're sending them up to the moon. We're sending them up doing secret missions around our planet. And these people here, they still believe in Howdy Doody. They still believe in 1950 morals. It's time to realize that the American people have to grow up. It's now 1985. I have proven myself. I've destroyed Backlund before.
Right,
I have retired the legend, Resnick.
We're all out of time. Remember, fans, this week, right here, Pro Wrestling USA, Larry Zbyszko, Bob Backlund for the American.